Welcome to Pretium Technologies. I am Venkat. This is part 58 of ASP.NET video series. In this session, we'll discuss about the techniques to send data from one web form to another. Before continuing with the session, I strongly recommend to watch parts 55, 56, and 57 of this video series. In fact, this is a very common interview question as well. There are several techniques that are available in ASP.NET to move data from one web form to another. We can make use of cross-page postback, which we discussed about in part 55 and part 56. We can also use context.handler object. We'll talk about that in this video session. And we also can use query strings, cookies, session state, and application state, which will be discussed in the subsequent video sessions. Now, in general, the members of one web form are unavailable from a subsequently displayed web form. However, when we navigate between web forms using the server.transfer or server.execute method, then data can be retrieved from the previous web form using context.handler object. Let's look at an example. Let's flip to Visual Studio. I have an ASP.NET web application here with two web forms. On web form 1, I have two text box controls where the user can enter their name and email. And once they click this button, go to web form 2, we want to navigate the user to web form 2. And we want to move the user from web form 1 to web form 2 using server.transfer technique. So server.transfer, webform2.aspx. Now once the user lands on web form 2, we want to retrieve the values that he has entered in these text boxes on web form 1 and display them in the label controls on web form 2. And to do that, we're going to use the context.handler object. So context.handler. And if you look at the handler property here, it's going to return an IHTTP handler. And obviously, the page class, if you look at the page class, if I right click on that and when I say go to definition, the page class implements IHTTP handler. So here, since the return type of handler is IHTTP handler, whatever it is going to return, that can be typecasted to be of type page. So I'm going to typecast that to be of type page. And then I'm going to use a variable called last page of type page. Okay, now all we have to do is we can make use of the find control method. So this context.handler, when we come from web form 1 to web form 2, the context.handler is going to give us a reference to web form 1. So this last page will now be pointing to web form 1. And on web form 1, we know we have two controls with IDs txtname and txtemail. So all we have to do right now is use the find control method to find a text box with ID txtname into which the user has entered their name. And then, if you look at this find control, it returns a control back, but we know that it's a text box, so I'm going to typecast that to be of type text box, and then retrieve the text property, which is going to return the value that the user has entered, and then display that in label name. That's it. And along the same lines, we are going to retrieve the value from txt email text box, and then assign that to label email. Done. So that's the only code that's required. So let's run this project now and then enter the name of the user and then the email. And once we click the go to web form 2 button, we should be able to retrieve the name and email. So I'm going to click go to web form 2. Look at that. I get name and email. So simple. But then this code can fail in a variety of different scenarios. So let's explore them now. Okay, so points to remember when using context.handler object. Context.handler returns web form 1 as the previous page only the first time when you land on web form 2 from web form 1. If there is a button on web form 2 and if you click the button, the page will post back and context.handler will return web form 2 instead of web form 1. So now, let's say for example, on web form 1, on web form 2, let me insert another row. Let's drag and drop a button control onto this web form. Now this button is not going to do anything. It's just going to post the page back. So let's rerun this page now. So that the point here to remember is, if there's a button on WebForm 2 and if you click the button, the page will post back and context.handler will return WebForm 2 as the last page instead of WebForm 1. Okay, and because of that we'll have issues. So I'm on WebForm 1, so I type in Prajim and test the email. I click on go to WebForm 2, so we are on WebForm 2. Now I click this button, look at what's going to happen. Object reference not set to an instance of an object, and this makes sense because on postback context.handler is going to return webform 2, okay, and that reference is stored in this last page object, and you're saying last page.find control txt name. Is there a control with txt name on webform 2? No, we don't. And then what are we trying to do here? We are trying to retrieve the text property out of it. So obviously, retrieving a text property on a null object will throw a null reference exception, object reference not set to an instance of an object. So how do we solve this? The simple way to solve this is to put a condition here. So if not is post back. It's as simple as that. Okay, now again, this find control method is a dangerous method. We have spoken about this in the previous sessions, but let me repeat that once again. By mistake, if I enter the control name as txtname1 instead of txtname, you know, a simple typo there, and then let's run this page now. Obviously, again, we'll get a null reference exception. So let's run this application now. And then when the page loads, when we, you know, the WebForm 1 loads fine, but then once we navigate to WebForm 2 after typing in, you know, let me type test and test, I click on go to WebForm 2. So obviously on WebForm 1, we don't have a control with txt name 1. So again, we get a null reference exception. And that's because we are using find control method. We don't get any compile time exceptions because that control is checked only at runtime. Look at that. When I build the solution, build succeeded. But when we actually run this, we get those runtime exceptions, which are dangerous. So how do we solve this? We can solve this using public properties. So on WebForm 1, I can expose the name and email that are typed into the text boxes using public properties. So let's create those public properties. So since name and email are strings, I'm going to say public string name, and I'm going to just have the get accessor because we only want to read the value. So return, where is the name present? It's present in txt name text box, so we are going to return that. And along the same lines, I'm going to make the email the public property. So public string email, and that's going to be in txt email text box. That's it. So what changes do we have to make to WebForm 2? Now on WebForm 2, we know that context.handler returns a page, but we know it's going to return WebForm 2. But the best way to check that, actually, let's do that. So context.handler is going to return, you know, since we are coming from WebForm 1 to WebForm 2, it's going to return for us WebForm 1. Okay, now I can simply get rid of this code. And then use on WebForm 1, we have properties. That's the last page. We have properties name and email. So we can directly use those properties. And these are going to solve our null reference exceptions at runtime. Because if you, you know, misspell the property here instead of name, I have name W. Look at that, there's a red squiggly indicating a compile time error. So the chances of runtime null reference exceptions are almost gone here. Okay, but the behavior is absolutely going to be the same. Okay, so when we run the page, we can type in the name and email, and when we click go to WebForm 2, you know, the page is going to work the exact same way. So Prajim is the name, test is the email, I click go to WebForm 2. We see the values, but then the chances of runtime exceptions due to misspelled control IDs are gone now. Okay, but then there is one more reason why this code might fail. That's because, look at that, if I directly, now let me run this. When somebody directly navigate to WebForm 2 in the URL, look at that, somebody can go to the URL and change WebForm 1 instead of WebForm 2. Now, if I press enter, Look at that. Unable to cast object of type webform2.aspx to webform1. Why are we getting that error? Because if you look at the code in web page load event, so if not is post back. So obviously when you type in the URL directly, it's not a post back. So it's going to come inside this if block. And then look at that, context.handler returns webform2 now because you're directly landing on this page. The handler returns webform2. Can we typecast webform2 webform1? No, we cannot do that. We are kind of trying to typecast maybe a car to a bus, which is not possible. Okay, there is no inheritance relationship between webform1 and webform2, so we cannot really typecast them. Okay, so that's why we get this exception. So how do we solve this? And again, it's very simple to solve. Instead of directly typecasting it as webform1, I'm going to say page. I'm going to say this as page as well. And then I'm going to wrap this inside a property. If page is webform1. So if the page object, sorry, if the last page object, sorry, if the last page is webform1, then typecast this to be of type webform1. And then retrieve the name property. Do the same here, and everything should work now. Okay, so now let's run this. So we are conditionally, we are checking there. If the last page is webform1, then only then try to retrieve, try to typecast the last page to webform1, and then try to retrieve the name and email properties out of it. So I'm going to type in the name as Prajim, and email as test. I click go to webform2. And it works as expected. And even if you directly land on webform 2, it doesn't crash, it doesn't show anything here because it doesn't come into this block. In fact, you can put a breakpoint and see what is last page when you try to directly land on webform 2. And you will notice that last page is actually webform 2 and not webform 1. So in this session, we have seen how to use this context.handler object to move data from one web form to another web form. In the subsequent sessions, we'll talk about query strings, cookies, session state, and application state. So for the context.handler to return webform 1 as the previous page, you should have landed on webform 2 using server.transfer or server.execute method from webform 1. If you land using any other technique, then context.handler would not work. The control values from the previous page can be accessed using find control method or using public properties. The problem with find control method is that if you misspell the control ID, we could get a runtime null reference exception. Using public properties instead of find control method can eliminate these runtime null reference exceptions, and we have seen that as well. On this slide, you can find resources for ASP.NET, C#, and SQL Server interview questions. That's it for today. Thank you for listening. Have a great day.